Hi everyone, welcome to our STEM Hackathon video. This video will show you everything you need to know about the hackathon, how it works, and how to complete each task. As this is a STEM set of tasks, you will be using skills in science, technology, engineering, and maths to solve the problems. You're not just restricted to design technology, although that's going to play a big part in all this. So let's take a look at what you're actually going to be doing. Simply put, a hackathon or hack is where you have to come up with as many solutions to a problem as you can. Once you've come up with a few ideas of how to solve the problem, you will then need to decide on the best one and develop it using sketches and notes where you will describe the hack in detail. You can create any hack you want. It could be a product that you invent and describe. It could be sketches or designing from modelling materials. A new website or app or social movement with no physical item is also allowed. You will then produce a final specification explaining what the hack must do. You don't need to build anything, but you can if you want. The best way to do this is with sketches and notes. So now that that's out of the way, let's take a look at an example hackathon challenge. Alex is 19 years old and is a public transport user. Living in the city centre is great, but when there's a big event on like the European Championships, public transport can get really, really busy. I would be happy to cycle places, but I do not want to get soaked in the rain. So let's look in a little more detail at Alex's situation. Alex lives in the city centre, so she normally uses buses or the subway. She can cycle a bike, but does not own one of her own. Normally she's travelling to work or the shops, so she does not want to get wet in the rain. Alex is a confident cyclist but has not owned a bike since she moved to the city. She does not have room to store one, so she would need to find another way of acquiring one. She does not want to have to carry her work clothes in a bag as they will get creased. She also does not want to wear a hood as that ruins her hair before she gets to work. Where could Alex get a bike in the city centre but not have to store it at home? Are there any materials that are waterproof but will not obstruct her view whilst she's cycling? There are lots of other questions you can be thinking about at this stage, so start making notes. Here's an example of some notes towards the solution that I've come up with. I've decided that Alex's main issues were overcrowded public transport and a lack of stylish and sensible waterproofs for cyclists. I did some research and I found that Next bikes can be found near her home and work. These are the bikes that you see all over Glasgow with the pink mudguard on the back of them. I've decided she can rent one without having to store it at her house. And I've also researched ways that you can stay dry when it rains. I decided what Alex really needed was some sort of bike umbrella that would keep you dry but also be easy to store. Using materials available, I made a model of the solution to see if it would work. But of course, for you, you will be able to use sketches and notes instead of having to model the solution. But let's now take a look at how I came up with some of my ideas. So in this first page, you can see a bit of sketching, some pictures from the internet. I've put some pictures that are available on the iPad on just to help me annotate my ideas. But I've just started to put my ideas down on paper here. So you can see two ideas here. The first one was I had an idea for a pop-up tent style sort of shield that she could have that would keep her hair dry and her clothes dry when she was cycling. You know, I'm thinking, can I actually use that pop-up tent idea to create this shield? So on the right-hand side of the page, you can see how I've got a small sketch or picture art of a bike, and I've basically just drawn where I think this would be best fitted on the bike to keep her clothes and her hair dry. At the bottom, I've put in an image of a Next bike stand in the city, and I've made a couple of notes, one about the bike hiring that's available all throughout the city in Glasgow, and some notes at the bottom right here about what I think my solution needs to do to make sure that I meet the brief that was given for Alex. So that's my first two ideas on this page, the kind of pop-up tent in the rucksack idea, and then there's the kind of shield over the bike idea. But what I'll need to do now is I will need to create idea three and idea four. So it's up to four ideas we're looking for you on the next page. And again, using pictures from the internet, using sketches, using the images that you can insert, use these with notes all around the page to come up with another two ideas. So now that I've generated my four ideas, this next page shows my final idea and loads of notes all round about it explaining what it's going to do. Just remember that this page should have as much information on it as possible. You've got to explain it to your teacher so that they can understand your solution to your hack without having to ask questions. Use images, use notes, use pictures to help you communicate this. This next page shows you a real-life solution that's been modelled for the hack that we've been talking about here. You can see the canopy that's see-through going over the bike and attaching to the bike so that the girl can see out of the bike but keep her hair and her clothes dry. We don't actually know if this would work in real life. We're not really interested in if it is going to be the final product. What we're looking for is a solution from you that fits the hack. The next page will be the specification page, and this is where you provide a list of the features and functions that your hack must do to meet the brief. So things like it must keep hair and clothes clean and dry whilst making sure the users can see all around, be made from lightweight plastic, unfold to a rigid shape and keep its shape during use. Pause this video and have a read through my specification here, which I've written for this hack, and you'll see the sort of detail from your research and your notes and your sketches that you have to include here. If you're unsure about what to do at any stage of the hack, you can go back and watch this video so that it will help you get through any sticking points that you have. So here are some top tips to help you manage your STEM hackathon tasks. Always read the hack card carefully. Pay attention to things like the age, the location of where the problem is. Identify the key issues and make a note of them. Use the internet for research and note your findings. Sketch or describe some solutions. It is advised to go for at least three and a maximum of four. Think about the solutions and decide on the most practical or suitable for your situation. Present your solution by describing it in a paragraph, sketching it, and adding notes or modelling it out of materials you have at home. Complete by adding your specification. And finally, there will be a template provided for you in Keynote to use for this. So you'll be able to treat it just like a PowerPoint presentation on your iPad. You'll be able to take photographs of sketches if you prefer doing them on paper. You'll be able to insert images you get from internet research. But just remember, we're not looking for you to invent something that already exists. The whole point of the hackathon is for you to use your creativity and design skills to come up with something that is innovative and new. Now, saying that, I don't want you to come up with solutions for problems that involve warp drive or instantaneous transport. Those things aren't realistic. It's really got to be something that is believable, that solves the problem in the brief, that we could invent in the near future, something that you know that works in another situation that you could bring over to this situation. So hopefully this video will be something that you can look back on while you're undertaking the hackathon challenges that are set for you each week. This is about you and your creativity skills, but remember, don't forget that you can use the help of people you've got at home to come up with ideas and bounce ideas off them if they think they will work or if they're realistic. So, I wish you good luck on the hackathon challenge, and most of all, I hope you enjoy them.